In this example, we find the final temperature after a hot metal is dropped into cold water and they reach thermal equilibrium. Our problem reads, a 1.75 kilogram lead block, initially at 98.0 degrees Celsius, is dropped into 435 grams water, initially at 21.4 degrees Celsius. What is the final temperature of the water and lead in degrees Celsius? The specific heat capacity of water and lead are 4.18 and 0.128 joules per gram degrees Celsius, respectively. To solve this problem, we need to realize that the thermal energy absorbed by the water is released by the metal, so Q water equals negative Q metal. This is the mathematical equivalent of saying that the energy lost by the metal is gained by the water. Our equation for Q is heat equals mass times specific heat capacity times change in temperature. We can plug in our values for water. We have 435 grams of water, 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius for the specific heat capacity, and the change in temperature is final temperature minus initial temperature, which is T final minus 21.4 degrees Celsius. For our metal, we want to make sure we convert 1.75 kilograms to grams. So we enter 1,750 grams for the mass, 0.128 joules per gram degree Celsius for the specific heat capacity, and T final minus 98.0 degrees Celsius for the change in temperature. Next, we'll need to plug these expressions for Q water and Q metal into Q water equals negative Q metal, and then we'll solve for T final. In order to solve for the final temperature, we can first use the distributive property on each side. We're multiplying what's outside the parentheses times T final and times the initial temperature. On the left, 435 grams times 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius times T final is 1,818.3 joules per degree Celsius T final. 435 grams times 4.18 joules per gram degree Celsius times negative 21.4 degrees Celsius is 38,912 joules. On the right, negative 1,750 grams times 0.128 joules per gram degree Celsius times T final is negative 224 joules per degree Celsius times T final. And negative 1,750 grams times 0.128 joules per gram degree Celsius times negative 98 degrees Celsius is 21,952 joules. Now we can get all of the T finals on the left and all of the numbers on the right. We can add 224 joules per degree Celsius times T final to both sides and add 38,912 joules to both sides. That will bring all of the joules to the right side of the equation and the T final to the left side of the equation. Combining coefficients, 1,818.3 plus 224 is 2,042.3 times T final. On the right, 21,952 plus 38,912 is 60,864 joules. And finally, we can divide both sides by 2,042.3 joules per degree Celsius to get the final temperature of 29.8 degrees Celsius.